There's always a difference when we do something other than the routine. Like taking a zigzag road rather than a straight road. Sleeping in the morning and waking up in the night. Visiting a hotel instead of cooking at home. Playing in a beach unlike indoor or outdoor games. Watching a roadside show, leaving theaters, and so on. The same way, there lies a difference when we express our thoughts in some way other than the usual language. Here comes the concept of poetry that refreshes, enhances, enlightens, and embodies the beauty of anything. Hello listeners, here is Giridhar back with yet another episode today, poetry in your favorite podcast, Giridhar's Garady. The word poetry is derived from the Greek word poesis, which means to make. It's a form of literature that uses aesthetic and rhythmic qualities of a language. Do you think lines that constitute only rhyming make a poem? No. I believe even the description of something in an extraordinary way that makes it pleasant to hear or read also can be a poem. Of course, rhyming is something that is catchy for everyone. You don't have to understand the language to appreciate the poetry. It exists in several forms based on the language, culture, tradition, customs, and many more. It can be about anything from early morning sunrise to full moon midnight, from life to death, from a source to destination, even on the minor of the minute things like an ant, piece of chalk, needle, or even on a name, place, and can also be on food. That depends on the poet. Well, on this context, let me share with you a poem that I loved like anything. Let me confirm you that I found this poem on the internet. It expresses the feelings of a cupcake in an amazing way. They put me in the oven to bake, me, a deprived and miserable cake. Feeling the heat, I started to bubble. Watching the others, I knew I was in trouble. They opened the door and I started my life, frosting me with a silver knife, decorating me with candy jewels. The rest of my batch looked like fools. Lifting me up, she took off my wrapper. Feeling the breeze, I wanted to slap her. Opening her mouth with shiny teeth inside, this was the day this cupcake died. Then we have some generic poems that specify a characteristic. Let me share with you another poem that I found on the internet with the characteristic opposites. I say yes and you say no. I say bye and you say hello. Butterflies fly and penguins swim. Professionals lie and adventures go on whim. If you go up, I go down. An emo to a happy clown. Girly girls pink and fat ones brown. Smiles right side up and frowns upside down. A rainbow to an opera sing. A rainy cloud to a sunny day. Bright colors and something gray. A beginning to an ending. A broken heart and then something mending. Now, there is one more poem that I read in a newspaper when I was in my school, and I did by heart this poem because I loved it like anything. It starts something like this. When you are in tension, you will lose your attention. Then you will be in a confusion. and spoil your friendly relation. Ultimately, you won't get any cooperation, and then you have to take medication. Instead, understand the situation and try to think about solution. Many problems would be solved by discussion, which could be better in any profession. Don't think it's my free suggestion. If you understand my intention, you would never get any tension. Alright, now I would like to share the first poem that I wrote in English, keeping in mind the Toastmaster of the Day role in a general Toastmasters meeting. For people who are not aware of Toastmasters, I can say it's an amazing platform to improve your communication and leadership skills. Well, coming back to the poem that I wrote, it starts something like this. Masters here are named with a toast. In every meeting, we have a new host. Who makes use of the stage most? Not necessarily hailing from a coast, but drives the meeting at any cost. May appear to someone as a ghost, but not here to make everyone a roast. By the end may seem to be a bit lost as they wait for a boost. But finally, they will be there in the MOM post. Any idea on how this poetry was originated? Well, we cannot say exactly, but it exists from the times when there were kings and their kingdoms. There were kings for whom poets were as important as their ministers. They were even ready to hand over part of their kingdom if the poets were able to impress the kings. Now, what are the elements of poetry? There are five elements, namely prosody, rhyme, lines and stanzas, visual presentation and diction. Prosody is a study of the meter, which is nothing but the basic structure, rhythm and intonation, which means variation in spoken pitch of a poem. Rhyme is a kind of creating repetitive pattern of sound. Lines and stanzas are used to create an organized form of poetry based on the expression or thoughts involved in a poem. Visual presentation is used to depict a poem with the help of a picture to attract the audience. Diction is an element which is used for the language in a poem, the grammar and the sounds involved with the usage of words. Now, what are the poetic devices? There are many, like alliteration, which means constant repetition of sounds. For example, it can be, she sells seashells by the seashore. Sounds interesting, right? Then we have one more poetic device, assonance, which is the repetition of identical or similar vowel sound in a series of words, phrases or syllables. For example, it can be, clap your hands and stamp your feet. Another form is rhyme. For instance, it is like, we took a look, we saw a nook, on his head we had a cook, on his hook he had a book, on his book was how to cook. Another poetic device is metaphor, which is a figure of speech that compares two things by saying one thing is the other thing. For example, it is like, he has the heart of a lion. Then we have one more device called personification that gives human qualities to animals, objects or ideas. For instance, it is like, the raindrops laughed with a glee as they jumped through the clouds. Now, what are the forms of poetry? We have various forms like tanka, which is a Japanese poetry used for a special event or to provoke a strong feeling. An example can be like wind blowing on my face, making my cheeks rosy red. It's biting my nose and chilling through all my bones. It is pushing me along. One more form is sonnet, which is a 14-line lyric poem that has one of several rhyme schemes. The other forms include ghazals or shairis, which is Urdu or Arabic poetry. And there is another form called shi, which is Chinese poetry. To sum it up, I would say poetry is everywhere and on everything. We don't have to be a pro in a language to become a poet. It's just that we could feel enough on something that makes us a poet. Then, what are you waiting for? Give a try. Who knows, there's a poet inside you as well. Kudos to all the famous poets like William Shakespeare, Oscar Wilde, Mark Twain, Makhanlal Chaturvedi, Sarojini Naidu, Rabindranath Tagore and others who inspired us with their poetry. Let's catch up next week with another wonderful concept. If you enjoyed listening to this, don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe. Thank you.